the last search will come in algebra all the way. Settled peace that people need today. I'm glad this evening to have that in my heart this evening. Lord, tonight, without Him, I'll not be able to make it. So I hope the Lord blesses you for coming out this way tonight, and I really do. I will wonder if somebody got something on your heart.
Like I said, it's going to be safe tonight.
Amen.
And I, just as I was leaving for our work, the guy that I work for, he told me to pray for him, have the church pray for him and pray for his mom, and I told him I would. And you know, it's a second time he's asked for that since I've worked at Fire Hill and Fire Hill for over 2 years. So just remember that.
God bless you, Pat. And remember this.
I just want to thank you for all the many blessings. Thankful that I can feel him tonight and know that he's here, and thankful that I know he's in my heart.
That's what we're about.
Thankful for the week he's blessed me with. And God, and there's just so much I can thank him for tonight. I'm just thankful that he saved me.
Amen.
Maureen, I have here a question. Like I said, thank God for the opportunity to be here. As you remember, Kyle before I left house, and some of Tiffany's family is in the hospital. I just remember them.
Bless you, Sean.
I remember my brother-in-law Mark again too. He's back in the hospital. He thought he was having another episode with his heart, but it's turned out it's a gallbladder, but they won't operate because he's just had heart surgery. So
I'm thankful to be here tonight. You know, you miss that on the service late Sunday, morning of Sunday night, but I mean, I got a blessing just Jimmy had shared, I'm sure others have.
Blessing.
I mean, just watching that Jim went in and lay down with Kenzie, man, and it touched me. And I mean, I got a blessing just, and I wasn't here, but yet,
right.
I still got a blessing to watch it, and I'm just thankful that. He understands I can't be
come
here.
On, Scott.
And you know, I'm thankful that he still blesses me even though.
Amen. God bless you, Scott. Amen.
Thankful I'm here tonight, Marty. I got a praise report. I want to share some good news with my church.
Yeah.
The one we've been praying for a lot of years, that we used to go to Leatherwood. We had got it last night outside back on the porch. That's me good.
Yeah.
Wasn't there, but I found it, boy. Just found it. I got a text last night from my cousin. I said, thank you.
Bless you, boss.
Good news, we won't hear nothing no greater.
Right.
We won't hear no greater news than that.
We won't hear nothing.
Bless me.
Bless him, Lord.
Well, I got an encouraging word for my church. Just pray on.
Amen.
Now, there's a lot more in my family. Been praying for lots of years, but guess what? I haven't stopped. I ain't got no intentions of stopping.
Right.
Pray on. God heard that first one, and he's going to do the last one.
Amen.
My church, pray for me and my family. God knows all things in that morning. He's been good to me and my family.
God bless you.
He's going to be good. You might be here tonight going through some things. God's going to carry you right through them. Like the way he did me and my family. He is no respecter person.
Right.
No, he brought Daniel out of lion's den. You know he's going to bring you out of whatever you might be facing.
Yes,
that good tonight.
Bless your body.
I'm just thankful I'm here. It's already been a good place for me to be, but we're going to make it better.
Yeah.
God knows exactly what that is.
Yeah.
You know? I thank you for the week I've had already. Morning. You know, there's a... I want to share this out. God bless me on my job. You know, one of the lift drivers down there where I work, he's got a ponytail about this long. And
bless
you know, some men might look down toward him the way he looks on the outward part.
Right.
He said, Bob, I've got a little 5-year-old grandbaby that got dog bit on the face.
Come on, Bob.
She's going to have surgery the 5th of April.
Bless you.
And I said... I'll pray for your granddaughter. He showed me a picture of her on his phone, beautiful little girl.
Amen.
You know, she's already had the surgery once.
Bless
but, you know, they got to go back and redo it because you still see a few scars. But my God's able to remove every one of those scars.
Amen.
Just asked my church to help me. The man's name's Bruce. I don't know his granddaughter's name. God does.
Yeah.
But he,
yes,
you know,
he
does. My prayer is for Bruce that... he may have seen something in me that, you know, because I never talked to him about my Savior before.
God bless you,
but, you know, I told him I would be praying. And, you know, after I did that morning, God just blessed me so good that day. And You know, I want to be a worker out there. I want to be more just somebody to build the house, you know. You know, because my God, he's going to provide all my needs. My wife's sitting here to tell you what kind of needs that he's provided for me and my family. And I come to worship and give him thanks for that.
Too,
you know, I want to thank him all year long. It's not just there's November that I'm thankful.
Yeah.
I'm thankful right now. You know, I'm God's been so good to me. Boy, I want to praise him, you know, just enter his gates with thanksgiving.
Bless your heart.
With praise, and I'm going to do just that.
Amen.
He made a way for me and my wife to be here tonight.
Yeah.
And I thank you for it, Lord. I thank you for it. It ain't all Wednesdays we get to come and be with you.
Bless you, Bob.
You know, I can tell you in my church this, that Bob and my wife will be praying. You know, God be our helper, we will be praying. You know, the nights that we're not able to be here. I love my church, and I got a desire to be here. You know, when he saved me back in 1998 at Raccoon Valley Missionary Baptist Church, greatest day of my life.
Lord, we stand in line.
Boy, amen. I want to go ahead and sing a song for him. That's okay. I want to
sir, brother. You know he's going to wish your heart, Bob. Amen.
That man Bob's talking about, my dad has a lot of confidence in that man. One of the first things when I texted Becky last night and told her how tickled I was that he got saved, the first thing he wanted to do was for me to tell my dad. And so, you know, that lets me know he got it. You know, he wants others to know about it.
Exactly.
It was a blessing to me.
Amen. Nice from here on. God do bless you. Yeah.
I prayed for salvation. That's how I first met him. Oh, I see wonders and great victory.
Bless the Lord.
There's been ocean.
Yeah.
can just think about, you know, I love that scripture in there where it says, I think myself happy. You know, you can think yourself happy, you can think yourself sad, you can think yourself mad. You can,
yes, sir. Mom.
You can think yourself of being sick, but
come on, Mom.
You know, I'm thankful that I'm happy. I'm thankful that I'm happy. You know, no matter how this physical body feels, I'm happy.
Right.
I think myself happy. And no man can change that, Marty. You know, I work with some, and I want you to pray for them. I'm not talking about them. I want to get something out, you know. I work with some that sometimes they have a bad day, and I know exactly what they need. That being my Savior. But, you know, I don't know if you work with these kind or not, but, you know, some of them, if they're having a bad day, they want you to have one more. You know, I'm not that way. My God's been too good to me.
Yes, sir.
You know, I told him, God's good. I said, you know, you don't have to go through every day of your life having a bad day.
That's exactly right.
I know what you need, and that being my Savior. I don't do that to be mean. I do that to, that's my daily prayer. That
bless him, Lord.
I like to say something to somebody.
Bless him.
That will be a help to them. And, you know, each time, like the man Bruce came up to me, you know, I get paid twice in the same day. I get a spiritual blessing that my Father gives me, and I get a paycheck. That He takes care of my family. And
bless him more.
Boy, he's worthy of our praise. And I want to worship him while I'm in here. I want to work for him out there.
That's right.
You know, that's my heart's desire.
God bless your heart.
I love my church, Marty. I've been praying for you this week, too.
Bless
and
you,
I'm thankful that y'all pray for me. I haven't forgot about Selma's niece.
Nope.
I haven't forgot that one, Marty. I haven't forgot about my other sister sitting back over near the back. Please remember my grandkid.
Yeah.
My grandson, I haven't forgot about that.
Amen.
Haven't forgot about Pat's two brothers. Haven't forgot about that neighbor. Haven't forgot about my pastor and his wife's family.
Bless
haven't
more.
Forgot about that boy. My pastor's boy hadn't forgot about him.
Come on, boy.
No, I hadn't forgot about him. I've been praying for all those that have recently joined.
Yes.
Because I know what things that will be coming at them.
Yeah.
Amen.
Come
on, boy.
Things came at me. But my God's good. He's good.
Bless you, boy.
He's been good.
Thank you, Lord.
My church, Jeremy. I thank you for the prayers.
Yes.
You know, when I'm up here singing praising my Savior, and I see Him bless you, guess what? That's a blessing too. It comes right back to me. You know, well, my brothers over here, when they get happy, guess what? I get happy too.
Amen.
And
then
I get happy too.
Yeah.
I need you all.
Yes, sir.
I need my church, Marty.
Yes,
sir. Every day, not just on Sundays or Wednesdays. I need my church family.
Amen.
You all. Don't know how precious that you are to me. You know, I've got neighbors that I can throw rocks to, but you know, right now that they're not in God's house, and pray for them daily. You know, I pray for them daily. I pray for this Easter play that's coming up. I expect something good to happen.
Bless you, Bob.
You know, I know when I see some of y'all's family coming back there. He's going to bless me, too, because I've been praying for that, Marty. He's going to bless me if any of them in my family comes. But if they don't, I'm not going to stop praying for them.
Exactly right.
You know, there was some saint out there that my wife didn't stop praying for me, Marty. You know, she got in church a while before I did. I was set at the house.
Come on,
she
Mom.
Said, I'm going to church. I'm going to sit here. You know, I didn't want to turn loose a few things, Marty. And,
come on, Bob.
You know, my wife, one day, just I know she kept praying for me, but one day I said, I might as well go. I might as well go. And, you know, I didn't have very many clothes. You know, but
come on,
man, my thing was okay to wear to church.
Right.
You know, I was clean. I took, and I got there, but you know, I had to turn loose some things I was clean in body, but I was dirty on the inside, Marty. And you know, the Spirit of God came down.
Oh yeah.
He said, Bob, I want you, boy.
Wow.
I got up from the third pew from the back, and that's all I remember. That's all I remember, but I did make it to the left-hand side of the altar. And
bless you, Lord.
You know, he just blesses me. I can go by this little building over there.
Come on, Bob, tell us.
Just on the side of the road.
Yeah.
It's just a little white block building.
Yeah. Sure is.
Beautiful building to me. The Biltmore house is not as pretty as this little white building.
Wow. This mind the Lord now. Amen. A lot of times, I don't know how other people are, but Mike, when my fuel gauge in my truck, and when it gets down around half a tank or just a baby mark or two below, I'll try to just go ahead and top it off some more. That way it won't cost me, you know, as near as much if I let her go down below empty. And this is the way I look at it. Coming here on Wednesday, it's a blessing. And maybe down about half a tank, Mike. And so you might as well just go ahead and top it off tonight. And the way you'll do that, you'll be obedient to the Spirit and that of God. And you'll not top it off if you're not obedient. Amen. This evening, and before long, time towards the end of the week, Bob, you'll be running towards empty pretty good. And, amen. And that's when the devil will come in there. When Christ began to tell Peter there, said that he desired to have you, that he'd sift you as wheat. But you know what the next verse there said? He said, but Peter, I prayed for you. Amen. When you're converted, why, strengthen thy brother tonight. So, amen. So we might as well just mind the Lord. And whatever the Lord's laid on your heart to do, you'll do that. Why, God bless you. He certainly will tonight. So we might as well just go ahead and top it off. Make the devil real mad tonight, and amen. So you just tell him to just get behind you. You're going to be obedient to the Lord tonight. Amen. I like Bob. I couldn't hardly make it without you. Amen. You could do along, get along just fine without me, Jeremy. But I declare it'd be. I just couldn't make it without my church family.
Bless You don't see no way out.
Come on, Mike.
I will show you Jesus. He's your ticket out. There is nothing for not the devil to do you, because the Bible says greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Satan and the Lord cannot occupy the same space. And the Lord ain't going to be the one leaving. It's going to be the Satan that's leaving, because he don't have the power. He don't have the power to rob you of your testimony tonight or your blessings. He give us all power. We have the power in him. The Bible said we're more than conquerors through Christ Jesus. That strengthens us. Don't listen to the way I sing it. Just listen to the words.
Right. God do bless him.
Pray to lift my head. I stand before you.
That's right. Blessed are those that hunger and thirst. Boy, I'm glad he did. But I'm glad I hungered man after what he had. I'm glad I wanted that salvation that he had so much in my heart and my life. And that I hungered to have that. And boy, I want you to know he gave it to me that Easter Sunday morning. And Lord, that I was so unworthy. Praise God, he still seemed fit and had to give me that salvation within my heart. And amen, Mike, and you know what? It filled me up. Amen, I'll tell you, I've never hungered and thirsted after that anymore. Amen, I'll tell you, it's good to be saved tonight. It's good to know the Lord this evening. He's my friend and my guy tonight, but I'll tell you, it's better felt than told to see this.
Yes, amen.
I've tried and tried to tell it, but I just can't get it told.
Yeah, bless me, Paul. Come on, boy.
Exactly the love that I felt within my heart.
Amen.
Amen. I'll tell you, I want others to have that same experience that I had. I want them to have that same love that the Lord gave me.
Amen. Amen.
So it is mine, the Lord. Amen. Mine, the Lord, tonight. He'll fill you up.
Amen.
He certainly will. You know, he'll even prepare a table before the presence of our enemies. Amen. Amen. He certainly will that you'll sit down and you'll dine.
Amen.
Just right before them, Bob. You certainly will. Amen. You know, I guess that last verse, Micah said, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Ain't that good? I'm glad tonight I'm dwelling in the Lord's house this evening.
Amen. Bless you, Father.
Boy, I'm testing the waters. You better mind the Lord. Amen. This evening. So whatever he lay on your heart to do, he'll bless you. I promise you tonight, he'll bless you.
Amen.
Amen. If you'll just be obedient to him. Lord, if you've got something on your heart tonight, don't leave with a heavy heart. Amen. To see tonight come and I just talk it over with him. I don't need to know a thing. I don't want to know a thing. Amen. I'm better off not to know what's in him, but I'll tell you, he's a good one.
Yes.
Story before and won't have it again. I got saved a long time ago. Like Bob, I got to the church. I sent out the house. My wife would take the kids to go to church. Praise the Lord. They got saved. I was sitting around there at the house and they'd ask me to go to church. And I still sit around there. We went up to late one Sunday.
Come on,
I was going to go to church. I said, I'll be all right here. She left. Yeah. Brittany was still there. She said, Daddy, won't you go to church? I said, well, I ain't got no clothes. They come and she turns around the closet. She brings me out some clothes.
Yeah. Yeah,
the Lord works in mysterious ways, and I'm so proud of it. I've told that story before, but I'm proud of it.
Amen. 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 Amen.
I could afford. He makes the good. said it again, and that's not a bad thing.
Bless her little face.
This woman kept coming to me and said, because you trouble me. I'm gonna answer.
Bless her.
Bless her little face.
But we have so many problems.
Come on, Barbara.
And I talked to 2 or 3 people today that's sick a lot. And,
bless her.
But we make the Lord so small. And he is so
big. That's exactly right.
Trust him enough. I know I'm speaking for mostly for myself.
Bless him.
But when we pray for something, we ought to thank him right there. Lord, he's going to do what's best for us. And I was just thinking about that, and I thought, I'm not going to tell that.
God bless you, Lord.
The Lord, you know, sometimes you don't want to do it, but he'll aggravate you to do it. And I'm one of them that don't do it. Bless
you, Barbara.
Yeah. And keeps on and on, and you have to do it. And, but it's always a blessing that the Lord tells you to do it.
Yeah, amen.
But I hope the Lord will let me trust him more. And when I pray for things, I'll get up and say, well, Lord, I know it's going to be done.
Amen. Amen.
God bless your heart.
I was just in the shop and we was just talking.
Well, Brittany.
This person had said, well, ask Brittany. And I thought, well, Lord, what's he got to ask me? And he started talking about the Bible and he had asked me a bunch of questions. And this man had told me that he didn't believe in the Lord before. And then he said, well, I see it now, you know. And he was asking a bunch of questions and I thought, Lord, help me answer them. And I was able to answer every one of them. And I'm thankful that he, a few years ago, I wouldn't have been able to do that. But I'm thankful that he gave me the answers. And he didn't know her for
miles.
And he started asking her the same questions, and I thought, Lord, please give her the same answers that I had, because I don't believe him. And she answered exactly the same way that I answered. I'm thankful that he's not the author of confusion. She gave the same answers that I had. And it wasn't easy questions that he was asking. It was very confusing and very hard questions, because somebody, I guess, that don't believe, don't really ask the list of few questions. They ask the ones that's
Yeah.
But I'm thankful that she did. She had the same answers that I had. She wasn't even there.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Bless Father. Amen.
Over there. No matter what life deals us once in life.
Yeah.
I'm saved. And I'm going home. And I thank God for each and every one of you.
Amen. Something still needs to be done. I feel it in my heart.
Lord Mary.
attitude you sent me. I'm really sorry.
God bless your heart.
I haven't been where I needed to be since I got here, and I apologize.
God bless your heart.
Bless her heart.
Amen.
Bless her.
Amen.
Bless her.
Amen. She's asked.
Amen.
It's our duty to forgive her.
That's right.
And I believe God loves an honest heart. How much better off I would be. I didn't say you, but I said me.
Amen.
Amen. How much better off I'd be if I'd just be honest to myself and God.
Amen.
I'm having a hard time trying to hide. Amen. Some more. Well, God knows all about me. Amen, because he is that big of a God.
That's right.
He is. And I'll just tell you something about that man in the middle. Amen. I'll tell you what he said, Mike. He said, Father, forgive them.
Yes,
they
know
what to do.
You know, Marty, I was thinking that forgiveness sort of goes without saying.
Yeah.
You said it's just something we do.
Amen.
Bless
him.
Amen.
When God saved us, he put that forgiveness in our heart.
Yes, sir.
It's like he put love in our heart. If you can't have one without the other.
Right, Mike.
Amen. No matter what you've done, God forgives us.
Yes, sir.
We need to forgive one another.
Yes. Amen. Bless you, Tiffany. God bless your heart.
Bless God.
Amen. You can't hide it from him.
No.
It'll choke you out. You're trying to hide it. Certainly will, boy. You'll try to peek to somebody of them getting blessed, and boy, you'll just want it so bad.
Yeah.
Amen, boy. Amen. And all it'll take is to sing God forgive me.
Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Bless God.
Marty, I was going through the living room this morning, and I happened to look up, and there was spider webs, you know, around the light. And the Lord showed me that around that light, them cobwebs and spiders and all, they accumulate. We get up there and we try to clean them down. But when our lamp, it gets dim too. It gets dirt on it too. The Lord showed me that we need to clean up our lamps, let our light shine, and we can see these lost people saved. We've got to get in shape to where the Lord can use us.
Yes.
And I want to get where the Lord can use me. I want to be a light to the people that I come in contact with every day, and I want to let my light shine that they can see Jesus in me. I'm saved, and I know that I am, and I'm on my way to heaven. If I die today, tomorrow, I'll meet you over yonder.
Amen.
You are my family, and I love every one of you. And I appreciate the welcome that you all have given us since we've been down here. And I love you to the love that's in this church. And I'm just glad to be here. I'm glad I'm a member.
Amen.
And I want to clean up my light to where the Lord can use me. And if we all try to clean up them lamps, let the light shine. We'll see these people. I've seen some actions, but we ain't seen no moves yet. It's coming.
It's
so we just have to stay down humble and pray and let the Lord have his will in our hearts and our lives.
Amen.
Amen, James. God bless your heart. Amen. So true. She was saying that, Mike, I thought about it. It's real easy sometimes to see other people's cobwebs.
Yes.
But not what we've got accumulated around.
Amen.
Amen.
That's the truth.
And he's talking to us just like, well, that's what's happening.
see it.
I'm grateful that
word is true. Yeah. Amen.
And I'm sorry because I've let the devil just get in and just eat at me. And I don't know what I needed to do, and I'm sorry.
God bless her. Bless her, Father. Amen.
Bless your heart.
Amen.
Amen. All forgiven.
Water and breathe.